Everybody, happy Sunday evening. Awake and on time tonight. On time. I'm awake and alert and not asleep. This past week has been really rough. I can't lie. It's been a rough one. Oh, Tassie! It's a Sunday night and we are out hanging out, playing in the street like we love to do. The boys just got done playing basketball. We're enjoying this beautiful, beautiful evening, you guys. So tonight I'm actually alert and Andy didn't have to wake me up from my dead sleep tonight. But if you are new here, my name is Tia Stokes. I am a mother of five, Major Legend Maids Taz and Rose. I'm 34 years old and I'm married to the handsome Andrew Stokes right over there. And 93 days ago, I was diagnosed with acute myeloid leukemia. And this is how we're journaling real life, everybody. Real life. All real life. Okay, come here. Come here. Come here. All real life. No edits here, guys. You get what you get in the Stokes family household. Today's your birthday, Tia. Oh my gosh, everybody wants you. Everybody wants Andy. Look it. Everybody wants Dad.
Oh, what's wrong? Got blood on your toy? Yeah. Let me kiss you. I'm gonna give it a kissy. Will Daddy give it a kissy?
No.
Okay.
Let me get her binky.
Give me sister's binky, please.
Her binky right here. It is a beautiful night tonight here in northern Utah. We are enjoying our night. I feel better than I did yesterday. I have been having like some bone pain tonight. Bone pain, you guys, it's the weirdest thing when you have bone pain as a leukemia, as a patient. Am I a patient? Leukemia person? What do you call yourself, a leukemia patient?
Yeah. Yes.
No. Patient. Not a person. Andy just keeps reminding me that I have cancer, so because I always have pain. And so when I get bone pain, I get it in my neck. I get it in my spine. Legend. I have headaches. And then tonight I get like my knees hurt really bad.
Legend. Come get Rose.
But yeah, so they send me home with pain medicine that Andy gives me when I have lots of bone pain. And I feel like I have a lot of bone pain going on. So my body is just like trying to protect itself. You know what I mean? So it's been I still feel like really swollen. I still feel really like just swollen in my hands, my joints, my face, just everywhere. It just feels really swollen still. So, but I think it's because I have lots of pain in my bones, and so we're just trying to take care of the body, you know. Tomorrow we're getting ready for our bone marrow biopsy. I go in the morning at 9 o'clock. We're gonna head up to Salt Lake. And I will be up there for a good, they're going to probably have to give me, I'm going up early because they have to give me transfusions before. So lots of prayers, you guys, for my bone marrow biopsy. This is either, they either want to see if my bone marrow is just being super sluggish on waking up or see what's going on. So hopefully my bone marrow is just taking a while and this last round of chemo just really gave my bone marrow just a good beat up, a good beating. So that's kind of the results we want, is just that it's just being slow. So hopefully it's nothing more than that, you know? So we'll be up there in Salt Lake for a long time. We won't be back till later, so be a while. Oh, look at, who's that guy? Wow. get in my glasses. Major danger. Wow. Wow. Yeah, no, I take, so for what I take for pain is I take Tylenol and, yeah, Tylenol. So I do that. So thank you for that information. It helps a lot. Huh.
What?
So grateful. Love you, Clay. There's my brother. Everyone say hi to Clay. And don't forget to drop where you guys are from. We love seeing where everybody is from.
Hi to Clay.
Oh, say it again.
Hi.
Say it again.
Hi.
Uncle Clay.
Uncle Clay.
Say, what's up, Uncle C?
Hi, Uncle T.
Say, I love you.
I love you.
Say, I miss you.
I miss you.
We miss you. So other than that, this week has been pretty rough. I felt really sick a lot of the week, just yucky, but that's mostly because I didn't get transfusions every day. I wasn't going into the clinic because they wanted to see how my numbers would do on their own. And so, yes, where's our ginger beer? We haven't had ginger beer in a while.
I think there's only one left. We could split it.
Yeah, we need to split it.
Mace.
We love ginger beer.
Well, give me the ginger beer out of the fridge.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
Hurry.
But, yeah, so they wanted to see how my platelets would do and my numbers would do on their own without transfusions. But, obviously, you guys saw we saw what happened when I didn't get transfusions. I took a big tank, so.
Throw it in the garbage.
We'll see tomorrow how everything's going. I'm still bleeding. So I'll be going to like my OBGYN on Tuesday to try to figure out what's going on with that. And hopefully they'll probably end up,
ginger beer.
They'll probably end up putting me on like a birth control type of things to help me. So with my hormones, our nephew just actually, cool news, just barely went back out into the mission field. He came home from Africa when did he come home from Africa? Like in...
Ask Uncle C's right there.
He came home like in February. Hi, Uncle C. Because of COVID, they brought all the missionaries home. And then he just barely went back out, but he went to Layton, Northern Utah. So we were trying to like see him, but I don't know if that's possible.
He said no.
Oh, he said no. So did you hear back from him?
Yeah. He said we could smell him some stuff.
Smell him some stuff. That's it? We can't even, like, accidentally pass by him.
I told him we'd mail him some McDonald's.
So we tried. Andy's been trying to get a hold of him, our nephew, because he's, like, Andy's little buddy. And he lived with us for a while. I don't know if you guys remember. If you followed me back before cancer, you probably saw Ammon. And he was, like, a part of our family for a really long time. And he lived with us. He played football for Andy. Such a good kid. Like, literally, he was like a big brother to our kids. And, yeah, he's amazing. So, Andy's been missing him and wanting to try to go see him. And has been texting him, but he won't let us see him. He said that we can mail him McDonald's or mail him a goodie bag. Did you get his address?
Good kid, right? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We tried to pressure him into breaking the rules, but he was like, nah, not having it.
Yeah, he's a really good kid, so he's not breaking any rules. This is the ginger beer that we were all just talking about. Ginger beer. And this one is, what's it called?
Cock and bowl.
Oh.
But this is not our favorite one.
This is not our favorite one.
The brown bottle. I can't remember what it's called.
Yeah, we don't like that one that much.
This is good. This is second best.
No.
Third best.
I don't think so.
This is third best.
I think I like the green one.
No, that's fourth best.
Really? Because I would say probably second for me.
Brannigan's or what is it? I can't remember. Starts with a B.
Yeah.
The little brown bottle and then green Fever Tree.
Yeah, those are good. So and everyone's this one. Maybe like we need to start doing like an 8:30 have your ginger beer. Everyone go get a ginger beer, you know? We can all have a ginger beer together. And don't worry, it's not beer. It's not real beer. It's not beer at all. Okay? It's kind of like root beer, but ginger beer.
It's exactly like that.
Yeah, exactly.
By the way,
Henry Weinhardt's root beer, best root beer ever.
It's yeah.
A good substitute for ginger beer.
Good substitute. Clayton said, Sunny Boy said that don't feel bad he doesn't even FaceTime us. He says he wants him hey, to miss
us. We don't feel bad. We're proud of that kid.
We are so proud of Ammon. We love Ammon so much, and we miss him so much. He was seriously such a bright light in our lives. He actually went, so before we moved up here, Andy moved up here first, which we keep talking about how much of a blessing it's been for us to move up here. Because we always said we would never move to Utah County ever, ever. We didn't, this is like the last place we ever wanted to live. And, when Andy got the job as a head coach at Tempview, which was like a surprise to me. Andy didn't even tell me that he got the job, that he applied to the job until you had the interview. Huh? And you told me on like a Tuesday and the interview was on a Friday. How rude is that? He didn't even tell me. So he ended up getting the job, which we didn't even think he was going to get the job. And he moved up here 3 months before me and the boys did. We didn't have Rose yet. And what happened?
Major.
What happened to Rose?
Okay, Major, you guys go in. Go in the house.
Go get ready for bed.
Go, take her. Major.
And he ended up, Andy left. Andy came to Utah County with Ammon, my nephew, to play football.
Fluffy.
Yeah, with Fluffy. That's his name. We call him Fluffy. Well, Andy calls him Fluffy. And
Fluffmeister.
Me and the boys stayed in St. George to finish school. And with we lived with my mom. We got the opportunity to live with my mom for 3 months, which was such another blessing. Don't you think that was a tender mercy?
Oh yeah.
Huh. We got so much time with my mom.
I feel like we lived with your mom also when we moved out to Hurricane. Remember that?
Yeah.
For a month. Yeah. Our house didn't get built fast enough.
Yeah, that's true. We did. Yeah, we had lots of opportunities to live with my mom. Oh, I'm gonna cry.
Stop that.
I'm going to cry.
It was good. It was good for us to have an opportunity to help Grandma. It was good for our kids to live with Grandma and eat toast and eggs every morning and learn how to put... I remember if you changed a diaper, you had to tie it up inside of another grocery bag. So we have our kids take the diaper outside, the outside garbage, every time we change a diaper. But Grandma wanted us to tie it up inside of a bag and then put it inside the inside garbage every time.
Yeah.
And she set her little garbage bags aside just for that purpose. Yeah. That was fun. That was fun, right?
Mm-hmm.
That was a good opportunity for all of us to be under that umbrella. Help building chicken coops and fixing gates and fun stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Took some of Uncle C's work off his hands for a month or so. There's the neighbors. So there goes that YouTube life.
What?
We're done. She's done.
I just miss my mom. It was just so weird.
Hey, but when you think back, like, we shouldn't have had to live with her that time. We moved from house to house in St. George, but we did. And then, like, obviously we know we moved to up here for a reason now. Like, we understand why. Like, even when I applied, I told Tia, I was like, I don't even know why I applied. I knew that if there's a high school job in Utah that I would take, it was this one. But like, we had no plans on moving.
No, we didn't. But
now we know why we're here.
Yeah.
Like, we're 5 minutes down the street from UVU. She can get blood transfusions at any time. And we're an hour away from LDS, which is one of the top leukemia clinics in the country. So we're lucky. We had great support down there too, but their support system up here has been like unbelievable.
Yeah, it's been crazy how much.
All that aside, right? Like, yeah. Moving in with your mom for 3 months was like probably part of the deal, right?
Well, it was just such a blessing. Like, it was such a tender mercy because we got so much time with her, like, yeah. One-on-one time. Like, my kids got so much, like, even though my kids are younger and they're the youngest of, like, the grandkids, like, they still got good memories with my mom and still had lots of time with her before she passed. And so it was just such a blessing, like, without even knowing it before, you know?
You want some ginger? Maybe clear your criers.
When I cry, Andy gets all weird. He's like, stop crying.
She's my little princess. And I have a new princess now, so she's been upgraded to queen. She's the queen bee.
Blow your nose, Tia. I know. My dad would tell me to blow my nose, but I have nothing to blow my nose with.
We got the wipes right here, dog.
With right now. Here, hold this. Blow.
Look it. We're all going to watch you blow your nose. Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Oh, yeah. See? Belinda says it's because I don't want to see you crying. Yep.
So the messages tonight is that you never know when what things, you know, like how you'll look back and realize that things were tender mercies and were blessings, right?
Yeah.
Without even knowing it. Like, our whole journey of how we got here to where we are now today with, you know, even my mom, just like the, you know, all those moments that we got with my mom before she passed. Like, I just, like, I, man, I just miss that old lady.
I think that I remember thinking at that time that that was an opportunity for our kids to, like, serve grandma and for us to serve grandma.
Yeah.
And to help her around the house and do whatever. But now as you reflect, it was probably more for us than it was for her.
It was, yeah.
Yep.
No. Yeah, it really was. It was a big blessing for us, especially for me, I think, as her baby, like the daughter, you know, the baby of the family. So, yeah, so you just never know. Like, you might not understand why things are happening at that moment and how things are happening. And even, like, right now with this whole platelet situation, I'm on day 50. I think this is day 54 of my round 2, which is so long. It's such a long round. Almost 2 months, you guys. Almost 2 months of this, like, round 2 that we've been going through. And for us right now, I'm kind of like, I don't know, this week has been, on top of like not feeling good, I've just been kind of frustrated, like just kind of upset. I've had my moments of like, just, I don't really ever say cancer sucks. It doesn't suck, but just my moments of like, what the crap is going on, you know? And
I think cancer sucks. We can say that.
No, we can't say that.
We can. It's real. That's the truth. The thing is, just because something sucks doesn't mean that you can't have a positive experience out of it, right?
Yeah, but... Right.
Lots of things suck. Most things that make us better suck.
It makes us stronger. Makes us better. Yeah.
Yeah. Cancer does suck. Nobody wants cancer. It sucks, but that doesn't mean it has to be a negative experience overall.
Okay, thanks, babe. You're right. Amen, Stokes. Everyone, amen. Agree. I know. I always try to be positive. I'm always trying to be, it's a great thing. Everything is awesome. Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why am I getting that look for?
Isn't she cute? Don't you guys think she's just a beautiful woman?
Shut up. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Anyways, so we're learning a lot. And like I just said, you never know why we're going through certain things, but we'll look back and realize what the lesson was and how it made us stronger and how it made us better and how we actually needed it to become more like him. So, just grateful for this experience, grateful for tonight. nervous for tomorrow. I just want whatever the Lord wants. Whatever the outcome is of my bone marrow biopsy, then that's fine. We just will have the strength to endure and the attitude to get through it and to be positive and to learn and to grow from it. So, and then hopefully we'll be able to start round three sometime this year.
We're grateful for the bone marrow biopsy. It's a good, let us know where we're at with this whole thing.
Bring those.
Wouldn't normally happen, but because what we're going through here. Taz is wearing Tia's sunglasses.
You're going to break them. Come here. He's going to break them.
He's kind of naughty.
Those aren't your glasses.
But he does. Hey, show everybody what you're drinking.
Hey! What's up?
So anyway, here's our neighbor, Big Rhett.
Oh, show Rhett. This guy. We got
to say hi to the whole world, Rhett. He probably doesn't want to.
Yes, he does.
What's up, Rhett?
Everyone needs to know about this guy.
This is live YouTube, man. You're talking about 10,000 people right now.
Not really.
Yeah.
You guys, this guy right here this is another tender mercy right here. This guy right here, Rhett, because when Andy was working on the house, he first started working on the house. Rhett just showed up. They had never talked before. He's our neighbor. And he just showed up at the front door and asked Andy, "What can I do?" And ever since then, that whole month when they were here working on the house, Rhett was right by Andy's side the whole entire time. And not only that did he help Andy so much, but he's actually Andy's friend. Isn't it so nice? Andy has a friend. Andy has a friend. And if you know Andy, he's a tough one to have a friend, be a friend to, you know? I'm just kidding. But he's been such a good guy and such... He came over and gave me a blessing last week Sunday. But he's been such a blessing to Andy and our family. And we just love Rhett so much. He deserves like everything. Yes, we love Rhett. He literally did my bathroom. He did all the tiling in my house. He did like so much in our house. What else did you do? The tiling? Oh, he hooked up my washer and dryer when Andy wouldn't.
Excuse me.
I'm just kidding.
Good.
Yeah.
That took more than two of us. That took like 12 of us.
No, he's been seriously so awesome and such a blessing to our family. We are so grateful for him.
Okay, go tell the boys. Go tell the boys.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. Tell me if you like it.
I'm
going to
like it.
And he's wearing his hat. Look at your hat. Look at that. Did you just put it on just to come over? Did you really have... Really? Oh, wow.
Have you ever fished for crab?
And guess what, guys? You guys can get those hats still on my Instagram, in my highlight bubble, TAT. You can get these hats that Rhett is rocking right now. That Rhett is rocking. Oh, Rhett, you're awesome, man. Thanks for being our friend.
Of course.
It's easy. People be friends with. Sure. We're the redneck family. Oh, Danielle says, "Hi, Rhett. Chaz and I think you're the bomb." Tanya says, "You are awesome." And Cambria says, "We love Rhett."
You are loved.
You are loved. He seriously is the bomb. Yes, everybody needs to give Rhett some thumbs up and some smash like buttons.
Rhett, we're going to go to West Monroe.
West Monroe?
Yeah. We're going to take a boys trip.
Oh, Danielle said you put her in tears.
Duck Dynasty.
Or put in years? Put in tears.
Yeah, West Monroe.
Yeah, he's amazing, you guys.
If you get on an airplane.
My glasses are from Tijen, T-I-J-N. They are blue blocker glasses. I wear these glasses when I use my phone for
hey,
all my...
Hey, you were telling everybody our plans.
Oh, Case, tell them.
Jeez.
Okay, tell them.
Cut us off.
Sorry.
If it's not Disneyland, we don't want to listen.
Okay, tell me what you're going to do.
West Monroe.
Louisiana.
Why? Where are you going to go there for?
We're going to go visit Duck Commander.
Oh.
And eat that kind of food.
Yeah.
And shoot ducks.
Okay.
Bring them home for you to cook.
No, I'm not cooking it. Sorry, guys. Not going to cook it.
When you go to Disneyland, we're going boys' day and boys' time. And Rose.
You guys are the bomb. We're at in Louisiana.
West Monroe.
West Monroe.
Actually, I'm going to call home and see if we can schedule a football game with them.
Oh, awesome. I love that.
That's a good idea.
I love that. I love
that. If anybody
that.
Is from Louisiana on here.
Yes.
Get in touch with West Monroe High School. Tell them what we're trying to play.
Yeah, Tint View. Rhett has, it's shrimp and what else was in there?
It's Cajun seafood. So it's got like potatoes, corn, shrimp, crawdads, clams, mussels.
Yep.
It's a good stuff.
It's a good mix.
Do you like that, Rhett?
It's spicy. Oh,
yeah. Really? Okay.
It's good too. I like it. My kids didn't like it though.
Yeah.
Dude, crawdad is like something.
It's a little too spicy for them, I think.
Crawdads. Have you guys?
Have everybody ever gone fishing for crawdads?
Have you guys ever been fishing for crawdads? It is actually so fun. It is really, really fun. It's a good time. You use bacon, and anybody can do it. I can do it. So if I can do it, anybody can do it. And it's addicting because you can catch like a ton of crawdads. It's so fun. You use bacon.
Bacon.
And then you just put it on the net. And you put it
down there and they come get it.
Put it down there and they come get it and just scoop them on up with the bacon. It's so fun. So fun. You guys should go do it. And then we'll just cook them. No, just kidding.
Once they grab the bacon,
I don't eat them.
They won't let go.
But that is our, tomorrow we are leaving in the morning at 9. Are we leaving at 9?
Yeah.
To go up to Salt Lake City. So we will be gone all day at the hospital.
Let me know if you like it, dude.
Love you, Rhett. Good night.
It's wet.
Thank you.
See you, Rhett.
You're amazing.
Is that a new truck already?
And we won't get the results. Always takes a couple days.
See you, buddy.
And then, so then we'll know. And then Tuesday we'll have our OBGYN appointment, but... on that note, Andy, do you have anything, one last thing to say?
Yeah, I do actually. Remember when they asked us how to have a happy marriage?
Yes.
I forgot one.
Okay, what?
It's the best one. I don't think we forgot it, but we just added.
Okay, everybody better listen to it. Yeah, listen to this.
This is the only thing you need to remember about how to have a happy relationship.
Okay, listen.
Relationships, it doesn't have to just be a marriage. My dad taught me this when I was like a naughty, bratty teenager. Trust me, I hit the go meter on all of those things.
He was the naughty teenager.
Yeah.
He was.
So.
He was very naughty.
He taught me a lesson one day.
He was very naughty.
He said.
He was very naughty.
If you want to
learn. You were naughty.
Okay, that's yeah, they got it. I was not the greatest child.
I'm just kidding.
But if you want to have. If you want to love somebody else, you have to serve that person. So I think it's a guarantee, 100% guarantee that if there's an unhappy relationship, one person in that partnership is not serving the other. So that goes all kinds of ways. Like if your wife wants to go to Disneyland, men, you take her to Disneyland. That's serving your wife. She wants to... run a dance studio
that makes that gives the money all away.
That's what you do because that's what she wants to do, and that's you're serving your wife. If you want to love somebody and you want a relationship to work, you have to serve that person. It's on you, it's not on them, it's on you.
Yeah.
And I see too many people like crying about their partner not doing a good enough job, or this just didn't work out. Yeah, it didn't work out because somebody was not doing their service.
Yeah, I agree.
So I think honestly, to make a relationship work of any kind,
you have to.
You only have to have one rule. You just serve that person.
Well, and I think that just goes hand in hand with being selfless. Like, you have to put the other person first.
Yeah, that's service.
Yeah.
You serve that person. And if both people in the relationship served each other, yeah, then you have a successful relationship.
Yeah, I love that. Love that.
So nix all that stuff we said before. Thing you need, service.
And the Lord.
Hey, that's the Lord's rule, people. You know what I mean? That's the Lord's rule. And that's the other thing. Religion-wise, if your spouse is religious, then you serve your spouse by respecting that.
Yeah. I love that. No, it's so true. And Andy does a really good job. I need to do better at serving Andy.
What?
Do I do service
You're
for you?
You're amazing.
I am?
Yeah.
What do I do?
Look at us. We like go. We have never taken our kids to a babysitter.
Except for nanny.
Except for family.
Family.
And only occasionally, so we've never had like permanent babysitting. But we've been going full blast since we got married.
That is true, Danielle.
You know, we are working around each other's schedules. We build our stuff around each other to make sure that we can be there for each other and all of that business.
Yeah.
So she's awesomer than me. Is that a word?
Awesomer?
Awesome.
More awesome.
I want to make a shirt that says awesomer.
She's awesomer than me.
You know, Tia has the glorious shirt. I'm going to have the awesomer shirt. Anyway, marriage 101.
Or doesn't just have relationship. To be marriage.
You know, your kids. You want to love your parents? Serve your parents.
Serve your parents, yeah.
Other way around works. Hey, you want to have a healthy relationship at the work facility?
Serve.
Same thing.
Serve your boss.
You know where this gets lost? Is boss to employees.
Yeah.
And bosses, if you want your employees to love you, you better serve them.
That is so true. I love that. I love that. I totally agree. And we're not perfect, but we try and do our best to serve each other. And Andy's really good at serving me. He serves me and takes care of me and lets me go to Disneyland when I want to go to Disneyland. Never complains. He's a really, really good example of that. And I hope that I can.
You're just glorious and amazing. Right?
Yeah.
She makes me a better human.
Oh, thanks, babe. I love you. Love you, love you, love you. All right, you guys. Well, there you go. There's our update for today. We love you guys, and we hope that we gave you a little bit of something tonight. Where can I pre-order your awesomer shirt?
I told Tia we need to get our own printing press.
He keeps saying that, but we don't have time for that. We don't have...
Hey, it's fun.
Oh.
That's like a hobby.
Oh my gosh. We're already so busy. Andy's so busy with football. You guys, he's a head football coach. He's got enough going on. Plus, we can't add anything to the list right now. So we'll keep... We can, though, get that shirt made with the printing company that we do have. So if you guys have... if you're on my Instagram, if you follow me on Instagram, we on my highlight bubbles, Tia Tees, we have a ton of merchant. I know a lot of people have been asking for merchandise, a lot of new people. So we have water bottles. Oh, by the way, look at my water bottle. I have a We Got This water bottle flask that I love so much. And there's tons of shirts, tank tops, hats, all kinds of stuff on there. So maybe we'll add our awesomer shirt to that as well. So... We love you guys so much, and we will leave you guys with a prayer. And tomorrow we will, our gratitude journals. We're working on those still. We got lots.
Who wants a gratitude journal? You know what? I'm done waiting for Tia on that. You know, sometimes I just, with Tia, I go, do you know what? Enough. Like when the doctor thing, when she didn't want to go to a doctor.
I didn't.
And I was finally like, you know what? Get your butt off of that couch. Get your shoes on. We're going to see Josh.
That's exactly how it went.
This is one of those moments right here. I'm going to do the gratitude journal.
We've already
started. I'm done waiting for her.
We are going to print it.
I already have the printer waiting. He's been waiting for a year.
Okay, well, we have it designed.
You were supposed to bring the design.
We have it designed. I have all my stuff in it that I want done.
I haven't seen it yet.
Don't you guys worry. My jewelry. Maybe I'll do a live tomorrow and take you through my jewelry collection. I have tons of jewelry that I can show you guys where I get it from. And then one more other person asked if my mom was sick. My mom was not sick. She graduated in her sleep. She graduated this life in her sleep. And kind of crazy because I think I felt her that morning and I didn't realize that's what I was feeling that morning until after the fact. So, yeah, but thank you guys for joining us tonight. We love you all and we will leave you guys with a prayer right now.
It's all you tonight, honey buns.
Kaz, you want to come say the prayer? No. Okay, I'll say it. Our dear Heavenly Father, we're grateful for this beautiful night that Thou has given us. We're grateful for all of our beautiful family members who join us on these nights to be able to be a part of our lives. And we are so grateful for all the many good people that pray for us and that bring their faith and trust in God together to be able to help our family out through this cancer journey and this opportunity that we've been blessed with. We're so grateful for our life and we're grateful for all the many people that serve and reach out and help us that we can always find ways to serve others and find ways to look for ways to uplift and serve those around us. We are grateful for the light of Christ and help us that we can all be able to have it with us at all times and we can be able to give it to others. Please bless our country at this time that hearts will be softened and our leaders will be able to be led by Thee and bless all the children that are suffering and that are lost this time that they can be able to be saved and we know that miracles can happen and that we know that Thou can work miracles and we ask Thee to please work a miracle with all these children that we may be able to help them and find ways to reach out and serve them and be able to come together as a country and as a world to be able to save all these children and make things right. We're so grateful for all our many blessings and help us to use our talents for good and help us so as be able to be a shining light to those we come in contact with. Please bless tomorrow as I go for my bone marrow biopsy that things may be able to go well and that the procedure will be able to go the way it's supposed to go and that we may be able to have the Spirit there and that His hands will be guided by Thee. We love Thee so very much and we thank Thee again for everything we have and we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We love you guys. Aloha. Say aloha.
See you guys tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.